More on the Philippine Central Bank's decision, chaired for the first time by BSP Governor Eli Remolona. As Lady Vicentia reports, the BSP raised its inflation forecast for this year and the next.
The Monetary Board of the Banco Central ng Pilipinas kept its benchmark interest rate at 6.25% for a third consecutive meeting.
The basic story remains the same. We have declining inflation rates and we expect to be within the target range in 2024 and 2025.
However, the BSP raised its inflation outlook for this year and the next, despite the consumer price index cooling for a sixth straight month in July. For 2023, Philippine inflation is now seen climbing to 5.6% from 5.5% due to the possible impact of transport prices and food supply constraints, which could be aggravated by El Niño. For 2024, the forecast was revised upwards to 3.3% from 2.8%. Both figures still well above government's 2-4% target.
Incorporated into our risk matrix, but not in the baseline forecast, but along with the baseline, we're looking at various scenarios. And even if we combine that with some other risk factors, it's not enough to cause us a breach of the inflation target in 2024. Of course, it still is a factor of the magnitude of the shocks. So if, for example, oil prices go up again,
the board also adjusted the GDP projections to factor in the slowdown of domestic consumption, but the BSP emphasized the lower growth rate in the second quarter is not related to the bank's monetary tightening.
If you look at the Q2 GDP numbers, it was a surprise to everyone. Very striking is the contraction of government spending by about 7%. So to some extent, the base effects may be present there, but also it highlights the need for different government agencies to ramp up their spending.
But at least one analyst believes the second quarter GDP growth may have influenced the decision of the BSP.
I believe it played an integral part in the post today. Well, the BSP, when it makes a move, it's always trying to keep a balance between price stability and the health of the economy. Given that we are seeing a downtrend in our inflation right now, both headline and core, though they are still elevated. And at the same time, the BSP saw a weakness in the second quarter GDP growth rate. If we're just going to talk about the second quarter GDP alone, then the BSP might have lowered policy rates. But then again, we also have this inflation picture that we are dealing with.
The Philippine economy expanded by 4.3% in the second quarter, slower than the 6.4% in the first quarter. Lady Vicentia, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Central Bank also commits to keeping a market-determined exchange rate. Deputy Governor Francisco Dakila made that remark amid concerns over a depreciating peso. The local currency on Monday hit its weakest level against greenback since November on the back of worries over China's economic growth and more rate hikes from the Fed. It also lost ground today, Thursday, closing 0.2% lower at 56.77. Dakila says the BSP has the option to intervene when needed.
We remain supportive of a market-determined exchange rate. And this is the best framework that allows us to concentrate on the achievement of our inflation target. The BSP retains the option to go and intervene in the foreign exchange market should market conditions warrant it.
Asian markets ended Thursday trade mostly lower following the Fed minutes. Japan's Nikkei 225 fell nearly 0.5% after its trade balance swung into a deficit in July. Australia's ASX 200 saw bigger losses as the country reported unemployment rate rose slightly last month. The Shanghai Composite, meanwhile, picked up 0.4% following the statement of China's premier that the government will work to achieve growth targets this year. Here at home, Philippine shares joined the regional slide, with the main index shedding 0.7%. PhilSox Financial's Japet Tantianco says the BSP pause was widely expected, but the market was hoping to hear more.
The dovish stance that many were hoping for were not heard today, and that might add to the negative pressures to the local bourse.